You're watching the World Pool Masters on Billiard Club Television, where the greatest players compete for professional pool's most coveted titles. Billiard Club TV is brought to you by Chalk Off, the complete pool table cleaner, and the official table cleaner of professional pool. Order yours today at chalkoff.com. And the Billiard Club Pro Shop, where you'll find the greatest deals on pool cues, balls, racks, and a whole lot more. For all your pool and billiard supplies, visit billiardclub.net. Billiard Club TV is your source for championship pool. And now, the World Pool Masters.
Welcome to the seaside resort of Egmond aan Zee on the Netherlands North Sea coast, where there's a party atmosphere for a local fisherman's festival. All the fun of the fair, lots of live music for families enjoying a sunny weekend. But when the sun begins to set, the party atmosphere moves indoors to the Hotel Zuiderduin, home of the partycasino.com Whirlpool Masters, where Raj Hundal of England is defending his title. 16 of the world's leading nine-ball pool players, nine nations from as far apart as China and the USA, Japan and Hungary. Each match a race to eight racks with alternate breaks. Among the stars, 17-year-old double world champion Wu of Chinese Taipei and snooker superstar Ronnie O'Sullivan. Up next, Ralf Souquet against Efren Reyes. The prospects from our commentators, Ted Lerner and Jim Wych.
Well, easily the feature match in the first round, Ted, and certainly one that a lot of people here are going to be looking forward to. The great Efren Reyes against the great Ralf Souquet.
Well, you're talking about two legends of the game, and both players have been resurgent in the last few months. So this is really a titanic battle that could prove to be one of the all-time great matches in the Masters.
But you know something, as tough as Efren is, and I mean he's the favorite in every event he plays in, Ralf's kind of had his number over the last few events, hasn't he?
Yeah, that's a little bit strange, isn't it? That Ralf really seems to have his number. But again, we've often talked about this, Jim. You know, what's on paper stays on paper. You know, what happens on the table is going to be a completely different story.
Well, listen, I know that as comfortable as these seats are, Ted, we've got a job to do. So, folks, enjoy this one as well. It's going to be a titanic struggle.
Just one match played in the bottom half of the draw. Majid awaits the winner of our next match, Ralf Souquet against Efren Reyes, a classic in prospect. And Jim Wych has been talking to Souquet, four times a winner of this event.
Well, Ralf, we're in Holland and the 2006 Whirlpool Masters. You're in great form, but you've hooked a tiger in the first round, but one you know very well, Efren Reyes.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough opening match, you know, to draw Efren Reyes in the first round. But over the years, I have a pretty good record against him. So I don't know if I'm his bogeyman, but that's how it looks like, because I might be the only player where he has a negative record against. So. Yeah.
The only one I can think of.
So I'll try to keep that in mind, you know, and just try to stay calm and, you know, play my game how I usually play against him.
Absolutely. And you've got Wu in your half of the draw as well. And players to look out for here, Ralf? Apart from yourself,
well,
of course.
I didn't even take a look at the draw. I just see the first match, you know, I'll try to win that one, and then from there on we can check the rest of the board. But I'm not going to go through all the bracket and, you know, who could I play or who couldn't, and because when you do that, usually then you lose first round, and then, you know, it was a waste of energy, you know.
You just keep knocking him in with robotic regularity like always, Ralf.
Thanks.
Yeah, all the best. Good luck this year.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Time to join the action then. It's a race to eight. Let's rejoin Ted and Jim.
The great Efren Reyes. What hasn't he done in the world of pool? You look on everybody's bio and they list Reyes as the player they all aspire to. He's the one they all come to watch. In attendance, you'll see many players with their notebooks and pens out. This is the man, folks. Okay. This is the man who has invented and then reinvented the game of nine ball. But up against him, if there is one person on the planet that has no fear whatsoever of Reyes, it's Ralf Souquet. Another former world champion has almost owned Reyes over the last little while, and it's the Kaiser who has the opening break. And the lag has been significant. Ted, looked at your notes a little earlier on. Everyone that's won the
first
leg
rack, Ralf
has
Souquet
won the match. And Souquet is hoping that trend continues. Here we go. Hold on to your seats. Rack number one of a possible 15.
And I've seen these two in some mammoth struggles over the years. It is always highly entertaining.
Lost the cue ball there. And Ralf demands perfection as we see the break again. Cue ball jumping in the air. Just a little bit of nerves possibly and adrenaline into that break shot. But you don't want to finish below the nine. A little bit of anxiety possibly too for Ralf. Made the one off the break. But it's safety on the two. And he's got just the kind of game to combat Reyes. He won't be happy with that effort. He's left Efren a chance at the two. And already a glorious opportunity to pinch the first rack against the break.
You mentioned, Jim, that about fans approaching Efren with pen and paper, pen and nine ball. Efren has... It's always been one of the dilemmas for Efren. He is besieged by autograph seekers and people who just want to stand next to him for a photograph everywhere he goes. And he is such a nice guy, he simply cannot say no.
He'd like to say no to that shot because he's overran intended position. And this three is not a bit, well, it's got half a pocket. A very tricky shot if he elects to take that one on. I doubt very much he'll play into that pocket. He's looking at the other corner. Blind pocket, tough shot. And it goes begging. And Efren will be the first to tell you when you get a chance like that against Souquet, you must capitalize. And what a let off for Ralf. And I certainly don't expect to see Reyes come back to the table in this rack.
Souquet recently captured one of the majors in the world of professional pool, the BCA in Las Vegas.
And didn't he beat Reyes there?
He beat Reyes in the semifinals of that match. As well,
Ted, back in January. In Kentucky, that man won the nine ball title there, and guess who he beat there as well? No prizes. Reyes again went down to Souquet. Ralf is far from intimidated by the magician.
Well, Souquet is one of those players that, I mean, he likes to play his own game. He'll tell you he doesn't really think about the opponent who's sitting in the other chair. But you know, Ralf, he raises the level of his game when a guy like Reyes is in the other chair.
He didn't knock that one in clean, and that's the reason he didn't get out to the middle of the table as much as he would have liked. So he's got to be a little careful here. No danger whatsoever. That one much more confident. And the miss from Reyes... punished to the fullest. It's the Kaiser who opens his account in this race to eight, secures the opening rack with his break, and it'll be Reyes coming to the table in number two. Expected, this was a clash of the titans. Rack 2 was a safety battle which Souquet eventually won to open up a 2-0 lead. In rack 3, a poor safety from Souquet allowed Reyes to run out and pull back to 2-1.
Boosted by that, in rec 4, a fantastic long 4 ball set up another run out for Reyes to level it at 2-2. When we got to rec 5, Reyes is at the table, but the veteran Filipino is in real trouble.
This will be some kind of escape, this one. Between the 2 and the 9. Are you kidding me? That was the only way he could get anywhere near that one, and he just about hit it.
That's worth another look. Look at this. Even though he fouled, that's amazing.
That is stunning. As it turned out, it was an error in judgment. He could have gone just below the 2, and I think maybe clip that off the cushion, but he didn't think so. But he intended to go between those two colors. Astounding shot from Reyes. But still, it's Souquet that comes back with ball in hand and one good positional shot from the 1 to the 2, and you'd have to expect him to win this rack. Very surprising choice for me there. Very surprising choice. I thought he would have played off the side cushion and elected to come down for the 2, but he played off the top cushion. He's still on the 2, as I said, and with a nice angle to get back to the 3. I think Ralph's starting to get into this match too now. And the way that he's played that, this 3 must pass the 6 and the 8 into the right side. No danger at all there. And it was such a good safety that Ralph played on Reyes. That's what bought him the opportunity to come to the table with ball in hand. And you rarely see that against someone like Reyes. Ralph's 37 years of age now, Ted, and it seems like he's been around forever, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, and that's because he wins a lot. And you see his name in the headlines.
Short work of this rack. The 9 to keep himself one rack clear. An all-important one rack, because they're now back on break again. 3-2, Ralf Souquet and Efren Reyes. A feast for everyone here to watch.
Now it's rack 6. Remember, it's alternate break, and this time it's Souquet of Germany who's in trouble.
Obviously, he can't get through to that top cushion. So he's going the side cushion first. This makes it a lot tougher. A lot tougher.
Ball in hand.
Geez, Ted, we had a look from our camera, and the only reason I can think of why Ralph didn't attack that one from the top cushion was simply because he didn't think he could keep position to the 2, because it was definitely available. But that's one that got away.
Well, you know Efren right up out of his chair, ready to pounce.
And Reyes came a lot further from the Philippines than Ralf Souquet did from Germany. There's no way He wants to book an early ticket back home after such a long distance traveled.
Just before that, Efren was in Bangkok for an Asian nine-ball tour event. Before that, he was in Las Vegas. He really gets around.
Yeah, never mind watching these guys. You'd like to be involved in their Air Miles programs.
But again, we can't stress it enough. Efren's never really far from home wherever he goes. Filipinos have migrated to all corners of the globe, and wherever he plays, legions of them turn out. He is a national hero. Not many sporting athletes in the Philippines, and uh-oh.
That's a mishit.
Uh-oh.
No excuse for that whatsoever. He overdrew it. He can't believe it. And he can't afford to lose this rack. This was his break. Looks like a very fine cut. May still be able to make the nine in the bottom left corner. But how missable is this? And the cue ball will be going around the world. There you go. Can't afford that. I think you can mark that one down because that could well be a turning point in this match. Just a horrible positional shot from Reyes. Unforced. And 4-2 to Souquet. Not only that, but the Kaiser will have the break in rack number 7. What a turnaround here.
On to rack 7, and a break and run out puts the German 5-2 ahead in the race to 8. Nerves jangling in rack 8, and a poor safety from Reyes lets Souquet in and run out. The German, going for an amazing 5th Masters title, is now 6-2 in front. But Reyes never gives up. In rack 9, it was Souquet who played a poor safety and let Reyes have the chance to close the gap to 6-3. We rejoin the action at the start of rack 10.
Thank you, rack 10. Efren Reyes to break, trailing by 6 racks to 3.
Michaela Tabb lets everyone here in attendance know that the scoreline is 6-3. Reyes to break. And he'd love that one to stay over that corner pocket. Again, the fact that this table is breaking so easily, that won't hurt Efren. Not known for having a big break, but this two goes into the corner. Even winning this rack, best he can do is 6-4. So he still knows that Souquet will be in control of this match with breaks in hand. Nice shot there. Check the cue ball off that side cushion. And for one of the very few times, we're going to see a break and finish in this match. And I hope I haven't put the commentator's curse on him.
It's been known to happen, hasn't it? Well, Jim, Efren looked up a little, doesn't like his position there. He's still got a heartbeat here in this match.
Yeah, but position has really been his downfall. You know, a couple very, very lax positional efforts from Reyes have been the reason that he finds himself 6-3 in arrears. And once again, not the best positional shot from the 7, so he's going to have to play a very good 8 to get back on track.
needs this nine to move within two.
Gets it, and he's pulled back to 6-4. It'll be Ralf Souquet with the break in rack number 11, but at least Sally gets a chance to warm her hands. Welcome back. This is Rack 11. Souquet 6-4 ahead is at the table. We'll just travel up about 2.5 feet. Ensuring to leave that angle and again back towards the middle of the table. More times than not, Ted, you find leaving that cue ball in the middle is the garden spot for these top players. Well, it can attack all quadrants of the pool table from there.
That's right. Increases your options. It's all about opportunity and options.
Now, Ralf doesn't want to be straight on this. And that's a bit of a mistake. And he won't be happy. And you see him muttering to himself. And two choices. One, stop the cue ball there and attack the 8 from roughly where the 6 is, or play a ton of backspin and try and get the cue ball back out to the middle of the table. And very seldom does Ralf Souquet ask too much from a shot. So it's going to be the dodgy 8. And the way he's playing, you have to expect him to get this. But he's not left the easiest of nines. Got three choices with this, and he's looking at the bottom right corner. Into a blind pocket. His line of sight will be looking away from this pocket. And this is all about memory. Understanding the angles and having shots like this in the past, because he just knows where to hit this. And it's all about execution. Oh, my goodness. Do you believe that? I cannot believe what I just saw. I didn't think Ralf would miss this nine in a month of Sundays. But Reyes deposits it. And hang on to your hats, folks. It's 6-5 with Reyes coming to the table to break. And Ralf Souquet, you just gave Efren Reyes a lifeline. Rack 12, Reyes at the table. 6-5 the score line. These two champions. And I don't know whether Reyes can get through to this too. He's right behind it. And if his reaction tells us anything, the answer is no. A few more chapters to be written in this book.
Oh yeah, baby, put the fish and rice on hold. We've got ourselves a match.
He can't get through to this. He's got to jack up and try and masse around this. And you can see it looks like about a half ball masse. It has been a story of millimeters this match. And it hasn't changed. He has to get this. He's playing it off the cushion. What a shot from Reyes. Sally again. And Ralph's dad in front. Didn't see any applause from him. This has turned on Souquet. It's done an about face on him. That missed nine in the last rack, how pivotal that might prove to be. Souquet knows as he's in his chair that at 6-6, having won the lag, the match is still in his control. But from 6-2 to 6-6,
you can see by the reaction of Efren that he's just not happy with his position play today. He's constantly looking up into the sky, scratching his head. But here he is. He was given up for dead.
But what has been Efren's downfall in this match?
There it is again.
Positional play.
Position play.
And again, he had plenty of angle on that. The mistakes he's made have been of his own doing. That's a terrible positional shot from someone like Ray. It's a terrible positional shot from any top player. But a great recovery shot from Reyes. And possibly asking for a little celestial intervention.
This is going to be tied up.
Well, the first 12 are in the books here in the Netherlands, and they've split them. Souquet won the lag, and he breaks in rack 13, and the lag could prove to be the difference in this match.
Visit chalkoff.com or call your local retailer and ask for it by name. That's Chalkoff, the complete pool table cleaner.
Welcome back to the PartyCasino.com Whirlpool Masters. In rack 13, Souquet broke and ran out to regain the lead at 7-6. The German is on the hill as we rejoin the action at the start of rack 14.
Rack 14, Efren Reyes to break, trailing by 7 racks to 6.
7-6 behind, Souquet on the hill, Reyes needs the last two for a place in the quarterfinals.
Well, three balls down, and he doesn't have a shot on the two.
He'll probably offer a bit of a wry smile. Nothing's changed as far as Reyes's luck off the break. And nothing you can do about that. So many people ask me what the secret is for the break in nine ball. If there was a secret, these guys would have found it a long time ago.
Push out.
Having said that, all Efren can do is try and force a decider.
Called the push out.
Souquet will come and have a look at this. And it just depends whether or not the angle is there for Ralph to be able to get that cue ball behind those colors. I don't think it is. But the blue two, is really the key ball to this rack. But as always, Ted, there'll be no decisions made in haste with Souquet.
Very methodical. You can almost see the thinking on his
The hand was offered.
Forehead there.
Go ahead, Mr. Reyes. Educate me.
Try your luck.
There's no way that Ralf would want to lock horns with Reyes in a chess match. And Efren is trying to turn this into a chess match. Don't know what he had in mind, but he's taking his time playing.
It's all riding on this shot.
Well, whatever it was, it didn't work. And if this two goes, it's very close. Reyes has played his last shot in the World Pool of Masters.
It can be cruel. You lose, you're out. Winner moves on into the quarterfinals. You come a long way. And it's a short race to eight.
Ralf's having a real good look at this, Ted. And he came down and checked where the three was. He's only got half a pocket here at best to play this two. I think there's more value in trying to make the two than playing the combination. Well, he played the two, but it struck the three, and that's taking the three away from the pocket.
Well, you didn't expect this to be easy, did you? The way things are going here.
Just flicked the three. That's probably as big a chance as Efren could have asked for, because certainly it doesn't look like the bank's available. The eight in the middle of the table takes that away. But there's a chance here for Souquet to try and run for cover, duck in behind that color. He's checking the bank. And in his mind now, confirming that the bank shot isn't the aggressive option. I think he's got to try and get that cue ball behind that four. Do you think, Ted, he's having a think about trying to make this three up in the corner pocket? That's what he's looking at now. He just went behind it and had a look. I just can't see Ralf taking that on. Can't see him taking it on. He's just had another look behind it.
Well, he knows the meaning of this, Jim. 7-6 in front. It's a race to eight. He's got the legend sitting in his chair, waiting to pounce on any mistake. For the bank.
Well, bank and the snooker. A shot to nothing. It was all about cue ball control as well. Possibly a page out of Efren Reyes's book. If he got it, he was nicely on the four. And missing it, he knew that he had a couple blockers. Biggest kick shot Reyes has played in a while, right here.
He's going to have to get lucky. But it looks like there's a shot for Ralf.
We saw Efren Reyes slice one of these in earlier. I've got a feeling that Ralf Souquet may take it on as well. Very, very thin cut. Coming down to have a look at it. The winning post is there, Ralf. One good shot on the three. No one said it was going to be easy. But I feel he's got to take this. to bring Reyes back to the table one more time.
That's true. How many times can you risk bringing Efren back? He wants this match over with. A foul. He completely missed it. And here it is. Efren Reyes with ball in hand here in the 14th rack. And we are looking at a deciding sudden death rack between Ralf Souquet and Efren Reyes.
Yeah, quick picture of Allie, Souquet's girlfriend. She's got beautiful fingernails. Surprising, isn't it? From ball in hand. See that smile, Ted? That's outward only. Because inside, we can't repeat on air what he's thinking.
How often have you seen Efren do that with ball in hand in this kind of pressure situation? It's almost a guaranteed run out with Efren. What do you think is... And he's always seemed to have bad position at that end of the table, too.
Bank shot. And yet another opportunity for Souquet from ball in hand. I've seen Reyes play. I've broadcast more matches of his than I can remember. And that's the first time I've ever seen mistakes like that from Reyes. From that sort of position, you just never see what you saw only seconds ago.
And this is a guy who can perform magic with 15 balls on the table. With just 4 balls on the table to do that is very unlike Efren.
And I can't see Souquet letting him off again.
What is going on here in Egmond Anze? This is amazing, Jim.
The pressure of the Whirlpool Masters. That's all you need to know. She's explaining it to Ralph's mom in a language that I would never even begin to understand. Well, that's a great recovery shot. I think under the circumstances, well deserving of applause.
And I think Efren, after making that last ball, took a big sigh of relief. Took a deep breath. He got a major gift here in the Netherlands. A major gift, Jim.
But he's got to take it to the bank. 7-7. And Reyes knows it is Ralf Souquet to break in rack 15 to move through to the quarterfinals.
Log on today to billiardclub.net or call toll-free 866-774-8770. Billiardclub.net.
the two competitors, Souquet and Reyes.
Thank you. The final
round. Duke it out.
Ralf Souquet to
right
break.
Down to the finish.
Oh, this is going to be good.
The 15th and final rack. And everybody on the edge of their seat here. One good break could forge the path to victory here for Ralf.
Got two balls down.
And it's there. That's all he wanted. Two down. And it's wide open. Reyes knows. The lag, Efren. You'd like to do the lag over. Everything in the open.
Well, we're not going to book his ticket yet, Ralf. Right? After what we've just seen.
Well, the finish line can be very elusive. Reyes is undoing his cue. Mind you, it's his break cue. So of no significance whatsoever. But you know something? Souquet saw it. I wonder.
Bit of a psych job.
Beautifully played. I think all those mistakes are behind Ralf. I mean, at the end of the day, he always knew he had the chance in the last rack with the break. And you never get to where Ralf is and has been in the world of nine ball unless you can live in the present.
That's right, Jim. It's the ability to put the mistakes behind you, to just forget about them. Ralf Souquet, one of the great thinkers in the game.
Little left-handed action. The only danger there would have been straight. And you know something? This isn't great. When you're looking at the 15th rack against Efren Reyes, you want it to be a cakewalk. Can't be simple enough. He's looking at the side pocket for one reason and one reason only. Because the angle that's offered to the intended pocket, the bottom right corner, is not what he had in the master plan. But it's going to be the bottom corner, and he's going to have to hit it at speed. And we've seen these pockets shrink up. As soon as a ball has been hit at speed, you better hit it good. I wonder what's going through Efren's mind. Deliberate as always. And that's why you always favor someone like Ralf Souquet, even under the pressure, because you know it won't be careless.
Well, he's made his choice.
It's in the side. He will play the shot eventually, Ted, trust me. But playing it to the corner, he would have to pound it in. Playing it in the side, he's got a little angle. The only problem, there's barely enough room for that ball to fit into that side pocket at that angle.
And this is the pressure of sudden death.
Ah, oh, what a shot from Souquet. What a great shot from Souquet under extreme pressure.
You get the feeling, Jim, that he'd just like to get out of this rack already.
Look how still he was when he hit that. That's a man in control of himself.
This rack can't finish fast enough for Ralf Souquet. And I think you're going to see a rather large smile, the first one of the match for Ralf Souquet after this nine goes.
Took a long time to complete, and there were some anxious moments along the way. But the victory came in the end, and the Kaiser, Ralf Souquet, continues his dominance over Efren Reyes. An 8-7 win, Souquet through to the quarterfinals.
Two matches now played in the bottom half of the draw. Majid will play Ralf Souquet in the quarterfinals. Two more matches to play. Next up, Thomas Engert of Germany versus Tony Drago of Malta. Six matches now played in round one. In the top half of the draw, Hundal will face Feyen in the quarterfinals, while Valdez takes on Alex Pagolian, an Englishman, a Dutchman, a Hungarian, and a Filipino. For more skills and thrills, do join us again here in Holland for world-class nine-ball action in the partycasino.com Whirlpool Masters.
You're watching the Whirlpool Masters on Billiard Club Television, where the greatest players compete for professional pool's most coveted titles. Billiard Club TV is brought to you by Chalk Off, the complete pool table cleaner, and the official table cleaner of professional pool. Order yours today at chalkoff.com. And the Billiard Club Pro Shop, where you'll find the greatest deals on pool cues, balls, racks, and a whole lot more. For all your pool and billiard supplies, visit billiardclub.net. Billiard Club TV is your source for championship pool. This has been a presentation of Billiard Club Television. For more, log on to billiardclub.net.